Happy Monday, everybody. We got something very interesting for you today. We are headed into ESPN Wide World of Sports.
Parking situation is nice and confusing.
Today, we are here to see a baseball game. We're here to see Brave spring training. I'm excited. I like baseball. We got seats for $15 on the lawn, like in the outfield, so maybe we'll catch a like home run. You never know. Let's get in there and check it out.
Wow, this stadium thingy here wasn't here the last time we were here. I wonder what it is. I wonder what kind of stadium it is. Because the baseball stadium is over here. That's where we're going. I don't know what this place is though. There it is. And also we noticed that there's a sign here that says that the new multi-sport arena is coming. So that's what they're building. It's a multi-sport arena. Oh, okay. So here's what we're not allowed to bring inside.
There's a photographer back here and he has like a little bit of self-defense with him or a prop for you to pose for your photo. One of the two. I'm leaning towards self-defense though. It's a dangerous area.
Good old Peg Leg Pete. I never knew he had a peg leg. But apparently he does. Oh look, spring training home of the Atlanta Braves.
We bought a ticket, but I just walked right in. I went through the metal detector, but nobody ever checked my ticket. But look at him.
We're here at the concession first thing. I'm thinking we might get a hot dog because that's a very baseball thing, but that buffalo chicken basket does look good.
This hot dog basket was $9.25. I mean, it's okay looking.
There's the actual view of the hot dog. I feel like the fries are worth it because this is probably the same hot dog we got at Casey's that one time. There's Adam the Woo.
Yes.
He's here with the...
chow down and watch some ball.
Yeah. Here it is. Baseball. We're going to be out there on the lawn, but I wanted to see from behind home plate. I wonder what they're doing. It looks like they're like watering down the clay over there. The berm's kind of big. I didn't realize it started all the way over here. And goes all the way to the outfield out there. This is kind of awesome. We could go down right next to the bullpen, and look, we can be right next to the outfielders. This like hill here is not for the faint of ankle. It's very steep.
Get a little behind the scenes of the guys warming up.
Yeah, here's the bullpen right here.
Gotta stay loose out there, fellas. Gotta stay loose.
Adam,
yeah.
I picked the perfect seat so where we can see everything that's going on perfectly.
Where
ready?
Is it?
It's right here. We're gonna sit right here.
And we're gonna get this view right, that's terrible. These are the pitchers and the catchers warming up right here. And also I wanted to show you guys here in the outfield berm, they run the foul line out into the home run area.
They just told us that there was a difference in price between the lawn and the berm. I think we paid for the berm, but nobody has asked us what our tickets were anywhere. So we could probably go sit behind home plate if we wanted to.
Should we?
Maybe.
Got me thinking now.
We also found out that these black tents behind us are like the VIP cabanas and they're $80. And they said, make sure you book the berm and then upgrade to a cabana.
$80 a party.
Yeah, $80 a party.
So for us too, it would be worthwhile if we had four people here. Maybe.
Yeah. We do have to admit, this is a pretty cool view from out here. Just some kids out here playing catch, which is pretty awesome. I got to figure out where we want to be. Do we want to be closer to the action or do we want to have the chance of a home run? Which one do we want? Oof. Did you hear how hard that hit? Dang. And the crowd goes wild. He's out here signing autographs. How cool is that? They just threw him a baseball. That was cool. Maybe they'll throw another one in here. I'm ready. Throw me something, mister.
Right over here. No problem. Hey, can you sign?
Signing stuff.
Right, you're about to see him outside. How's it going?
He's wearing his head above as a hat. Here we go. Here's the first pitch. Ooh, a hard strike. Ooh, there's the first hit of the game. Foul ball. I love that they do the sound effect from Finding Nemo of the seagull saying mine whenever somebody hits a foul ball. Ooh. Holy cow, this stuff looks a lot better than the hot dog that I ate earlier. They're getting ready to do something that I'm pretty sure is going to be projected onto the Jumbotron. He just tried to make him propose to his girlfriend.
Jeez Louise.
Ooh, they're doing an awesome like competition where they have to get dressed so fast. Look at how fast she got dressed.
That was quick.
Holy macaroni. These are like little tiny hot dog sliders.
It's a mini bra and a mini zinger.
Oh, those look so good. I feel like something that, ooh, look at that. A lot of people don't know about sporting events is that you can kind of meander around and get a lot better view than what you had with the seats that you paid for. You just gotta be willing to stand. Ooh, he's giving him a signal. He's saying, move out, move out. Ooh, look, this must be a big hitter. Here he comes. Oof. Foul ball. Something's gotta happen here. He's swinging for the fences too. That was it's quite a swing. Watch, it's gonna go right to where we were sitting earlier when we moved in here. Ooh, he got walked. Dang, that was exciting. End of the inning. I missed it. Somebody tried to steal second, and he got thrown out. Ooh, it was a diving catch. He caught it. That was exciting. Dang. So we're supposed to be out there. Right now we're back behind first base, just hanging out. Apparently it's totally okay as long as we don't go inside of the black line. We can pretty much go anywhere we want to in the stadium. Ooh! Oh! Man, that was exciting. Here's my issue, is everybody has the same color on. How are we really supposed to tell? It's gray pants and white pants. There's a random bird walking around the field. I feel like he's behind this cameraman right now. Oh, there he is. Do you guys see him? That's a baseball pigeon right there. It looks like you can also rent out an entire tent for maybe your company or something like that. How cool is that? We are going absolutely everywhere in this stadium. We're in the perfect spot to catch this foul ball. It's gonna come up right now. Ooh, all right, that was a strike. That was a hard pitch strike. Ooh, I don't know where it went. Oh, there it is. Look at how close it is. Wow, that was so close to us. Ooh, ooh. Oh, dang. I have to admit, probably the hardest job in this entire stadium is this guy down here with the floppy hat and the red shirt. Because what he did is he took photos earlier and now he's scanning the audience, try to sell them to the people that he took a photo of. So he has to find the person in the photo in this audience. Wow, this is quite a view. I feel like this pitch or this hit could come at us at any moment now. What if it does? What if it comes flying right at the camera?
I'm not gonna protect you.
I wouldn't know what to do.
I'm gonna move.
I would let the kid get it.
He's got the glove.
Ooh, oh man, I thought he was gonna swing at it and I thought it was gonna come right at us. Oh, all right, I lost it. Where is it? What's going on? What is it? Where is it?
Down the third base.
Oh, okay, there it is. What happened? Why did everybody whistle? Dang, I can't follow anything that's going on. Oh, she's yelling at the players. Alan, Steve, ooh, oh, I don't know. Look at this, look at this, look at this, look at this.
Could be.
No, oh man, that was almost bouncing over. Man, these Braves.
Oh, look at it, everyone's doing the tomahawk chop. That's what it's called, right?
I think so. I'd like to watch the game from up there. How do we get into those booths? We're up on the second level now. Over here, right where the foul ball just went. We figured the best view would be right next to this guy, because he knows what's up. Oh wait, he's looking over here. I should be looking over there.
Right here.
Ooh!
Ooh!
Man.
Foul ball.
The perspective on that really threw me off. I thought it was coming right for me. Ooh, that was one heck of a strike. Ooh, I like it. I want to be an umpire. And just yell, brrr! I watched Finding Dory the other night, and that's what the seals sounded like. Ooh! Oh, he's running. We should do like every, oh my goodness. Look at this.
It's a pop-up, it might fall in.
Look, he's got it. All right, nice catch.
That's why he's a professional.
We should do every, how do I get this kid's job? I want to name off who's batting. All right, so, whoa, there's too many things happening. That umpire just really cleaned off home base really fast. But I want to do like every.
That's the one thing you notice? Out of everything here.
Yes. I wanted
his cleanliness?
No, what happened was he went like
he took a little broom and he swept the plate off.
Yeah, you do like this, but he was like
he's got a game to call.
Here's what I want to do.
What do you want him to get on his hands and knees and like give his little elbow grease?
No, I
want to
do like he's gotta have some finesse to it, not like he's too excited for an umpire is what it is. Listen to him yelling.
That's what they do.
Here's what I want to do. I want to do like
like every baseball yell that we can think of. Like, we want a pitcher, not a belly itcher.
I forgot about that one. That's a good one.
Yeah. We want a catcher, not a...
belly scratch? Catcher? I don't know. What am I supposed to say?
Not a chicken scratch. What? What is it? Catcher?
What?
Catcher and pitcher rhyme. You can use the same one for each one.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. Chickens.
The TV is focusing on this kid that's dabbing so much. And he was up on the Jumbotron. But nobody is kung fu fighting. Adam, get up and kung fu fight.
I don't know how to kung fu. I would get a leg cramp.
That's true.
Pull a hammy.
Oh, this guy just bunted. And now all of the... Oh, wait. Nobody's moving in. Nobody trusts his bunt. Except for maybe third base over there. They sort of trusted it a little bit.
If there's two strikes and you bunt and you foul it off, is there you get another at bat, or are you out?
No, you get another at bat. It's just a regular old foul.
You are out.
What?
Nope. If you bunt a third strike and it fouls off, you're out.
Oh, dang. You just missed that whiff.
You would never be an umpire.
I know. Ooh. Did you hear this? This whole team back here got excited.
We got some excitement up here, finally.
Right. Yeah. Just a little. Ooh! Look at that! Look at it! Go get it! Dang! Oh!
Ground rule double!
Ground rule double! Oh no, he just caught it and threw it back. What is he saying? What is it? Oh, he's just saying two. Okay. Ground rule double. Like, no matter what, he could have ran to third. And it would have only counted as two. He had to go to second and stay there. This could be the first run of the game. There it is. Oh, two runs. Look at that. Oh, like everybody's doing their chop. At least four people are doing the tomahawk chop.
You know the distance between the pitcher's rubber, what they call that little stand area he's on, and home plate? You know how many feet it is?
45.
60 feet, 6 inches.
Why is that?
Because that's just what it is.
Ooh!
Was that a ball?
No, nobody called anything.
I called it.
He probably called it.
I said, was that a ball?
Oh my goodness! Oh, he's making it. He's running home. He's running home. Dang. The Braves are up 5-0. Gotta clean it up. Just running some chain link fence. Behind yourself. Well, they're giving away free registration to a Run Disney event.
To a Run Disney event on the East Coast or West Coast. Just go out there, steal that base, get back here in 20 seconds. You ready? On your mark, get set, run, Cadillac!
She cheated. There it is. Okay, she's got to get back in 10 seconds. I feel like she can do it. She did it with 1 second to spare. Now she can run in a Walt Disney World marathon. The Atlanta Braves saxophone quartet. All right, Detroit, it's not looking so good for you guys. It's 8-1 right now. Ooh. Oh, it bounced into the stands. Oh, we're doing the Cuban shuffle now. Oh, it's coming. Where is it? Oh, it's going over there. Man, we're doing the Cuban shuffle again. I don't know why we've done the Cuban shuffle so much. Some people aren't giving up on it. We got up and started moving around a little bit. Now we're sitting right behind home base. Ooh! Oh wait, look, everybody's looking up. Man, they've lost a lot of balls this game. One beautiful baseball sunset over there. So interesting being able to just like roam around the entire stadium all the time and just see what's going on everywhere. Ooh, that was right where we were sitting.
We were right there.
Ah. All right, I may have gotten second dinner because those other foods look so good. This is a pork belly Cuban. Back out here on the berm where we actually paid for tickets for. And the sunset is starting to look beautiful. Holy cow, I got like a super chip. What the heck version of Come Together is this? We came all the way to the furthest point that any spectator could be, and I wanted to show you guys the cage that's around the scoreboard to protect it from fly balls. I also wanted to show you this unique perspective of the game. This is through the fence, all the way out in the outfield. It is a pretty neat perspective being out here at the outfield wall.
just outside of it. There it is. Location number 16 for watching the game. Oh, awfully interesting how quiet the baseball game is. I just realized we're sitting kind of right behind the dugout here. Quite a different feel from the soccer game that, or the football game that I went to. Look at how bored this center fielder is. Oh wait, he got excited. Nope, bored again. We're at two strikes, two outs, almost into the seventh inning stretch, the best part of a baseball game. Ooh, strike three. There we go. Middle of the seventh. Now we all stand up.
The saxophone quartet is going to come out and sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game. They're doing it.
Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and crackers.
We haven't had any Cracker Jacks.
We'll get some.
Don't care if I ever get back, and it's root for one of these teams.
Who is it?
If
they said Tigers, that was
win, it's a shame.
I don't think they're going to win.
Because it's one, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
Yes! Let's get some Cracker Jacks.
Let's do it.
Bad news, Mr. Adam the Woo.
You promised me Cracker Jacks.
I did promise you Cracker Jacks, but the concession stands are closed. Cracker Jacks, $3. Closed.
One, two, three out at the ball game.
Yay! We got Cracker Jacks. We did it. We're in a new place, directly behind home plate. These are the good seats. The excitement is abounding. Like this guy practicing. Look at, he's getting ready. Ooh! Look at that hit! That was amazing!
Can't get
we
it
got
up.
Cracker Jacks. What prize did we get? Oh, is it a temporary tattoo?
Yeah. It says, go ahead, throw the curve.
I like it.
I gotta admit, the crowd over here is a little bit rowdier. Oh look, everybody's doing the chop.
Just watching the game, and then I looked down and I noticed somebody left an entire tray of french fries down here.
Here we go. Bases loaded, nothing to lose. You're up 11-3. Let's see what they do.
Oof.
Oh. Third out.
I'm
telling you guys, the only thing that keeps happening is Adam keeps handing off the Cracker Jacks to me. Look, there's nothing left, and he just keeps handing me an empty bag.
Oh, double play. Double play. Dang. They don't score anything. That was the middle of the eighth. Look at this mass exodus of people right now, because it is 11-3. There's pretty much no chance of Detroit coming back from this one. In our final location, we're down a little bit closer to home base. Oof. Oof. We are one out away from the end of the game right now. Oh, that was one heck of a strike.
Everyone's cheering.
Oh, oh. All right, there it is. End of the game. That's it. Atlanta wins. There it is. The final place we could be. The closest to the field you could get. Oh, these people are just going onto the field. There's just a door there. We could go.
Michael gave us a free pretzel. This is awesome.
Free pretzels. They're handing out free pretzels all over the place here. There go the kids. They're running around the field. They came out at like 1,000 miles an hour. Cleaning up the stadium, sweeping out all of everybody's trash. Game's all over. And there's a nice little photo op here with Horace, maybe? I don't know. We were just leaving, and I looked up on the roof here, and I was trying to figure out what the heck this thing is. What is up there? Kind of looks like a half-eaten turkey leg. Is it a shoe? What is that? So the game's over. Everybody's leaving. It was a lot of fun. Like, that baseball game was a lot of fun. It wasn't as rambunctious as the soccer game, but it still was a lot of fun. But I do have to get home, so I will see you guys tomorrow. And now it's time to pay the price.